southernmost point of the United States shell collection. Hey Brett, 90 miles to Cuba, you can take a swim. Huh? Right there is Cuba, straight out there. It's a boat. Brett's gonna go swimming. Where's Brett?
90 miles to Cuba.
What happened to Michael?
Where's my hat?
What? What? What do you got?
How do you blow one of those?
Huh?
How do you blow one of those?
That's not the kind you blow. That's
just a... Yeah,
no. Mom, let's go find Mark and your brother.
Yeah. Yeah.
I got plenty of room, Brett. I think I'm running over.
There you go. And if you want to help us with that,
Michael, get over there and take a picture.
Not to say that you're storing something on the old telephone.
Wave.
1867.
Hi,
Dad. Michael.
Yeah. Want to get in together, sir, with some... Let's have a look at us. Yes, we're off. And here we are, sir, at the southernmost point of the United States of America. We're 90 miles from Cuba, 157 miles from Miami, here in Key West, Florida, America's Caribbean island. Key West is situated at 24 degrees north of the equator, and as we stand here, sir, we're 360 miles further south than Cairo in Egypt. Where you're standing, sir, is the end of US 1, where you're 2,209 miles further south than Fort Kent in Maine. The southernmost point, continental United States, in Key West, Florida.
To what?
Walk right in the... Hold
off. Whenever you're ready.
Just stopping or standing. You can't stand still over there.
Let's follow the three tourists on their way out of Key West, southernmost part of the United States. Don't walk in traffic, Michael. That's a tail file. Very good.
You're not. You get on.
I know. I'll have to squeeze over. The chaperone's leading the group. Heading back to her.
Recording stuff.
What are you recording? Michael, you can't record from back there.
I can record out the window.
Recording the car.
I'm not recording the car.
He's recording the car.
It was recording this way.
For a second. This is Key West.
We're unimpressed.
Yeah, my mom hates it.
I don't hate it. I'm unimpressed. I'm
unimpressed, another word for hate.
I'm going to the beach.
I'm zooming in. Ooh. Let's see if we can just find it. I can't read the names of the things since you're going so fast.
Soda.
Ooh, that's a nice house. Boing. It said play lotto here. Ooh. We didn't pass Ernest Hedlund's house.
I don't know, stop. They'll eat things there, and you'll eat things there. Go.
Oh, Wendy's. Lunch buffet.
There's a bar, Pizza Hut. This town is not what I thought. This is not the Key West I thought.
There's Burger King. Sweet Pig.
Why don't you wait to the last second? You have a chance to turn the on time, but as soon as you're right in front of the night time. 1 pound Maine lobster, 10.95.
graders have red faces right now. They've already been outside for one of your classes, right? It's pretty humid out there. Welcome to D.A.R.E. graduation, moms and dads, and we have some grandparents in the audience, and we'd like to welcome you to Citrus Elementary. This is a really a special occasion for the fifth graders because they've been working very hard for the last several weeks, learning some very important lessons. And the lessons that they've learned over these weeks are lessons that we truly hope will carry with them over the lifetime. We know that this is the easy time right now, and we hope that those pledges that they've made today will carry them through the next several years. So here we're here today to celebrate. And we're here to celebrate the pledges and the promises that they're making to you and to themselves. So good morning and welcome again. We have some special guests this morning, and I'll just introduce them and let them stand up. And then we have a very special guest to speak this morning. We'd like to welcome Lieutenant Mike Dean, who also happens to be Andrea's dad. So Lieutenant Dean, stand up and welcome this morning to Citrus Elementary. And a parent. And I'll introduce him again in a second, but we'd like to welcome Mr. Billy Wilson. Billy, stand up, and we'll talk a little bit more about Billy. And then we'd like to give a special welcome to Officer Hughes this morning, who's here today. This year we decided to have somebody come in and speak a few words, and we thought about who we might have come in to speak to the young people, who might provide a role model or somebody that you could look up to and say, you know, I'd like to be able to make some of the same decisions that they...
Say no to drugs by whatever means necessary. You've been taught by many ways to say no to your DARE program by Officer Hughes. We all hope, and we all have hope in each of you. You have just completed 18 weeks of training in the drug resistance program. You came willing and ready to learn. I am sure that you listened, shared, participated, and asked questions of the DARE officer. I hope that you will carry away to middle six and beyond this new knowledge. Use it and spread it. Hopefully, you will influence others, allowing them to become aware of the dangers of drugs, and giving them the incentive you have to become involved in other extracurricular activities, such as sports and music, and other things. These things will keep your minds away from drugs and keep you free of drugs. You have completed the first step in the drug awareness program, DARE. It is a beginning, and it's a good beginning, and one in which we must all invest our hope for the day when we will no longer need the DARE program, for the war on drug abuse will be over and all citizens will be clean and free of drugs. Therefore, my final words to parents, get totally involved with your children. Know their friends, know where they are. But most of all, involve yourself in every aspect of their life. To all the fifth graders, my congratulations to you for completing a successful fifth grade year and completing the DARE program. You are the future of the world, of our nation. You are the ones who help heal the world, make it drug free. Thank you.
An exciting way to learn about drugs. Officer Hughes taught us about drugs in a fun way. He taught us how drugs harm our bodies and how to say no in eight different ways. He taught us how to deal with peer pressure and to believe in ourselves. We learned about the consequences of drugs and alcohol and how to deal with stress. In another lesson, he taught us how to deal with drugs in the media. We also learned about our support system and how it helps us. The high school students that came taught us about the pressures in high school and how to deal with that. As we move from Citrus to middle school, junior high, and high school, we at least once will probably be offered drugs. And because of the D.A.R.E. program, we will probably be able to deal with it better. D.A.R.E. is a fun way. D.A.R.E. prepares you for the things and pressures you will have in the future. I would like to thank Officer Hughes for taking the time to teach us about drugs.
Medicine or preparing medicines. Drugs are obtained from plants, molds, minerals, and are often made from chemicals. This is a helpful drug. A harmful drug like marijuana is a substance taken for its effect and not for medical reasons. Such drugs speed up or slow down the activity of the body. Before my DARE class, I didn't understand about drugs too much, but after I didn't know practically all I need to know about drugs. The DARE class is a learning class and is not like a regular class. This class is fun. I learned from Officer Dylan Hughes that you don't need to take drugs just to fit into the group or to be cool. To me, you're a lot cooler without them. Your decision about taking drugs or not will be the most important. important decision you will ever make. Officer Hughes also taught us a lot about the different types of drugs and how they can hurt you. He told us about marijuana, cigars, PCP, LSD, uppers, downers, and a lot more. D.A.R.E was the most interesting program I've been in this year, and the fun was all thanks to Officer Hughes.
All right, y'all, I want to get everyone to get start trapping in, just get a beat going.
Important parts of life as we enjoyed ourselves and even played games. D.A.R.E. program is a wonderful program that teaches students the pros and cons of drugs. This brings to mind one of the first lessons we learned in D.A.R.E. Drugs can be good, helpful, and life-saving things, but if they are abused, they won't help you at all. Though it was probably meant to be the most important issue, a lot more lessons were taught in the program than just about drugs. With Deputy Dylan Hughes' help, we learned more about values, support groups, and how to say no to drugs, how to play fair, and not make a big argument out of life. We also learned about what life is going to be like in the future years of our life.
D.A.R.E. is cool, it's out of sight, it teaches us what's wrong or right. Pot and coke never mix, but the human race is a deadly thing. Deputy Hughes is really cool, he teaches us to stay in school. The workbook's been a great resource, D.A.R.E. has been an awesome course.
We'd like to go ahead and let it last 6 hours and let every student come up here and do their presentation. So, because each student did a job as well as the students that did presentations, and it would be great to have a chance to let them all tell you what they've learned. But what I do with those is I collect every one of those presentations, and anytime that I'm talking to parents or organizations and they want to know what the D.A.R.E. program is all about, I let them read some of these presentations. And like I said, that says it all. Now.
Vincent Gavin. April Lorifus. Beasley. Misty Bell. Tula Bogan. Jessica Brewer. Vernon Chambliss, Brett Denninger, Paul Denniston, Tara Dugan, Angela Fiorillo,
for you and for me and the entire universe. Woodstock. What are you doing? Whoa, where's the tiny one? Jimmy.
Good
is Michael. We'll meet Jimmy. How you got? There she is.
Where are you at? 41 extra minutes.
Oh, isn't she look great? Hi. Full energy. Smile. Christmas. Ho, ho, ho. What's the thing?
Are you ready for what's stuck out?
Jimmy Cricket. Jimi Hendrix.
What's that? I'll give it to you in a second. Go sit down, Dad.
I have over here. I got.
No, you gotta stand up.
I'm gonna be standing.
Okay, stay right there.
Dog went to the bathroom on the floor over there.
I'll pick it up in a second. Alright.
Oh, thank you.
What's that?
What
did
you
get
out for?
Because Dad gets his first.
He
had to be standing to see it.
Wow.
Go ahead.
Ooh. Oh, you sound real excited.
It looks great.
You asked for it. You got it.
I did. That's what I wanted.
Good. Go fresh to watch the deck now.
A little cold for that. It was wet.
It was really, it's like 20 degrees outside. We were just out there.
It was?
I'm serious. It's like 20 degrees. And we were out there like this.
Wow, look at that be, Brett. What is that, Brett?
I think it was the only one I could find in stereo.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So I'm going to put the garbage in the tripod.
No, wait.
Save the bowls because there were no bowls left. Michael, could you just get a bag and I'll put it up? Just take it off. Where did it just go? Michael can't garbage. Santa's got a garbage bag.
Ho, ho, ho.
I didn't know Rudolph gave personalized presents.
So we got a people to write on there.
You have to open two.
What are you
doing? Wait a minute. Can't you just put that somewhere?
Like where?
Where's the tripod?
In the closet.
Put it on top of the TV.
Yeah.
We'll film anything from there.
Yeah, you will.
Yeah.
You won't get anything. You all have to sit in the exact same spot. This heap of working. Wow.
Michael,
what's that? Piece of paper.
I'll open everything.
Come here, bro.
Ho, ho, ho.
Brett, you're not even looking to see who these things are from.
No, it took me a long time to make.
Yeah.
Is that mine?
It's
a
from
slipper. Thank you.
A what?
Slipper.
Oh, no help. I'll use it.
What do you mean?
Better than that brown one I have.
What are you doing to it?
I'm looking at it and trying to do it. You guys are feeling the pride, huh? Thank you. What's this? There you go, Brad. There you go.
Oh,
I heard something about Jimmy Stewart last night or something. I thought it was in it, but it's not.
Well, thank you, Bleach. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Who was that for?
You.
Okay, where'd I put my
cash? Oh, you're crunching up all the clothes.
No, I know, and I'm more hungry.
Yeah. I'll try to recycle them.
Ho, ho, ho.
Here, Mom.
Oh, where's it? Michael, how do I put the date on this thing?
What?
The date.
Set.
This is.
What?
Just tell them what date it is.
No.
Why, man?
Oh, I think we'll send that 28.
I got the date on. Why is it still flashing?
Why don't you get the tripod?
It's flashing.
So, in utero, thank you. You're welcome.
Well, there it is.
Now, why don't you go get the tripod?
Be really careful. This one's sort of head in the middle.
Yeah.
You're really sucking up here.
They have mommy on it.
I did that.
Did you see that?
I do.
What time is it?
It's supposed to repair.
CD-ROMs or CDs?
You can film it after.
What's that? What's that?
You get the tripod in the closet, Mike. Go on for work.
What's that?
Thank you.
Where's Jimmy? Jimmy!
He looks
well. Isn't that big? Yeah. What's that says? See that? Come here.
Look like fuck. Call him, Michael.
What's that?
One's
into
one end and one's
into
the other.
No, Woodstock, go to the other
Woodstock,
end.
Woodstock, go to the other end. Don't try to steal it from here.
Oh, what is this? Oh my God, it's heavy.
Open it up.
Open it up.
There's somewhere in my left. Whoa.
Trying to break it.
Oh, thank you, Michael.
Thank you. Thank you.
You got the two things, you just so I can guess
do it. Tear it open with one hand, Dad, you know.
Huh?
The thing on your lap, just tear it open.
And guess what the other present you got me is?
Thank you.
Thank you, Michael.
You and I was up for a black light for you yesterday.
Wow, that's a blue shirt.
Oh, I like that shirt.
Yeah, it's a shirt just like,
yeah. No, you know, look at it. Hold it up.
Thank you. Woodstock and Jimmy.
Yeah, there's two.
What are you talking about? Yeah, don't open that one yet.
The bag comes up. He had this on close up the whole time.
Okay, this is sort of heavy.
Is anybody chewing on that huge bone?
It'll take a while to eat. Jimmy was on that.
Oh, I saw this. What did you do? I saw this in the store. I wasn't sure what it was.
Well, because you're interested in movies. It gives you information on all movies and everything.
Open sure
it. You like that?
Yeah, thank you. I saw it in the store. Just
see, that's why we like to buy stuff that's not on your list.
The thing that looks like a rectangle. Put your hand in that one,
too.
Isn't that?
What's
it's
that?
Lost Boys. Thank you.
And it wasn't cheap, so don't think that it's like worth nothing.
And how much it was?
In the camera over here.
How much it was? You didn't scratch off the price.
It's on now.
I mean, you see, I thought you got me a CD, we used to give them CDs to each other, so I'm like, looking for a CD down there, they gave me a, I need to give me it. I need to see if I was
okay. Okay, Dad, you ready? Go sit down. Just get a little wide view of the room, you don't have to focus in on any of the project.
It's on pause, you know.
No, it's on record.
Okay, yeah.
You changed it?
Mom, if the red light's on, it's on record.
I'm just, I can't get, man, I'm trying to get a wider shot.
We just go back all the way.
That is all the way.
Well, then that's it. Sit where Jimmy was sitting.
I'm glad you want me to
sit. Gee, Dad, you didn't know how to put the pressure on.
What I'm trying to get.
I know.
I have your head and I have Brett's. That means you have to sit in the middle.
What's that trying to wrap her toy up on?
Right eye.
Jimmy. Yeah, you're real excited about that pressure washer. We'll
I know, how can you get out for you because it's 1800 PSI.
Yeah.
Good.
There you go.
So move over about this. Yeah, the pictures, you're at the end of the picture spectrum, so it's red.
Right.
You guys sit over there.
I know, I got it somewhere else because he took too long.
Oh, well, I told him we're going to get the service from him again.
Well, what? I called him and he said, go get it somewhere else.
Hey, Mom.
Oh, look what Daddy did.
I know.
You can't open those till last. Those are the last. This thing worked?
Thank you, Dad, for making a cool looking car.
He said, don't open it till last, right?
You open everything?
I guess.
Oh, Michael, hand it out. Stop you.
They didn't open up there.
Oh, those little shaky things.
What?
You guys didn't open up.
Look, Santa's stuck in the roof, in the chimney.
Thank you for the card. Thank you for the card.
Welcome.
Right, very nice, but thank you.
Oh, Gumby!
Shut up, Mom. I thought they were from me and Brett last night, and I go, hey, Mom, did you forget to wrap that Gumby on the counter? She's like, oh, no, Dad had some stocking stuffers on the counter for me.
Well, thank you, someone.
Huh?
She has another box.
Thank you, Mom.
We have plenty of other boxes. We're open these first.
Oh.
They're thicker.
A Christmas rule.
But listen, Mom.
I couldn't get the water in that Christmas.
Elves can go things.
I don't know. You, what does that say?
The instructor cleaner says some work.
Some assembly required.
Look out.
Look.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Is this my stuff?
Yes. A million times, yes. Yes.
That's mine.
No, it's hers, Brett. I put all our stuff right there.
You don't
have one. Oh, what could this be? Oh, a Gumby. What do I do with it?
It's for your keychain. Whoa, you got me a gum lighter.
Dad bought it, right?
Dad and Mike.
Yeah.
Oh, Matt, what do you call it?
Triceratops.
Triceratops.
Look at this.
Oh,
back to the
freedom.
Future.
Thank you.
Now I'm going to have to rearrange the whole video collection.
Excellent.
Now
you can watch that.
Oh, look.
Let me buy
I'm the third
that
person
Gumby.
To get a Gumby.
Then
hey, look,
Gumby.
Huh?
Must
be
inside.
Oh, it must be an omen.
Those toenail clippers. I'm always asking for them.
I'm going to put that in the kitchen.
Classroom, it's a paperweight.
At Rock?
Hello.
It's cool.
Mm-hmm. You can shoot your classroom for when is it windy or something. You know? Yeah. You don't like them?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, sweet, Brett. Thank you, someone else.
You're trying to tell you something, right?
At the bottom of them, Michael.
What?
Thank you. I got lots of them.
She's also trying to tell me something by getting
your
gun.
The top of my desk. You obviously haven't been in my classroom lately.
Reference card.
Oh. I didn't want to put specific names.
Okay.
Oh, he's up here again, but
Dad kind of got mad.
I'd like some relatives.
Mom, where are you going?
You have a tape up it.
Dad's okay.
Dad, you never open that.
Oh, look at this baby.
Are these yours or are these Mom's? Didn't...
Your mother's.
She likes spreading all the couch.
What is this? Underwater Majesty, a 16-month calendar. Shut up.
Okay, I'll open this now. Whoa, it's a stereo. I had no clue.
No way.
stuck.
Max, Babe, Misty, the first and Max.
What's that? Don't touch that chocolate.
How come I didn't get anything from the cats?
You did, probably. Ooh.
Whoa!
Look at that!
Cool.
And it has the UFOs on them.
Hey, that's cool.
Can I sell them for $30? I was going to say, I thought
they were. Yeah, Jack, can you slow down a bit?
Wait a minute, Mike.
Well, we can only come from Misty and Max and everybody else.
No, your presents aren't done. Go sit down. Go sit down.
Michael, can I have another bag?
It's here. Right here. Sit down.
I have another thing.
Ooh, what's this?
What's this big thing? What's this for?
Oh, yeah. Hey.
Blue jeans.
Oh, yeah.
I thought you forgot about this because I saw the blue one. I thought that was it, but then, oh, that's cool. Oh, yeah. Well, that's what I mean. I need a band. Here, what? Oh, I need a band. Thank you. I need a band. That's Mom and Dad, thank you. Well, I can't wait. We'll wait for him to garbage bag on number two. What's Jimmy? Jimmy, you didn't even show him his poster. I really,
where are their presents? In the stockings.
You gotta get them out.
Go get them,
someone.
Oh, no,
no,
we'll do them
one.
There you go, Mom.
Yeah.
You didn't show Jimmy his
namesake on his poster.
Oh, from Mom and Dad.
Smell good. Sniff it.
I know. You put them in the drawer.
Show us the rope thing.
Because I have a speaker or
something. Hey, dog. Where you going?
Is that everything?
Hey, Jimmy, there you go. Yeah, except for the cast boys. Whoa!
Frank,
look! Look what the cat's got! get out of here, dog! Watch it! Okay, it's open.
Dad has something in his.
What?
Why put these candies back in the stock?
Yeah, that's what
I put thought. Something in Dad's earlier.
Ow!
Get the stock, give Fred a stocking, and he beat your stocking and put them back in.
Yeah, what about yours?
I didn't get any chocolate.
Dad did.
Yeah, and Dad.
Oh, now mom
did.
And Dad.
Santa Claus didn't give me any chocolate.
You idiots, that's not a tug of war thing.
If that thing he does, they think it is. I think anything is tug of war.
Are they playing?
I guess.
Are they trying to fight over the same toy?
I guess. I'm not taking a close look. What's get that? Out of here, dumb dog. Hey, get down. Hey, what's this? Oh, I must have missed it. Ooh, I can see what it was. I saw the shimmering in my eyes. Open up, you dumb package. God, what did you guys do?
You open up your thing, you just wouldn't get your cats, I guess.
10 layers of wrapping paper.
What? What are those?
Ooh, look, I got special Walgreens edition. I'm totally on filters. How about you, Brad?
I got normal edition. You know, I'm not special.
Mine says Walgreens. Ha ha. Dad, you for your chocolate. Oh, yeah.
That's it, Michael.
Huh?
That is chocolate.
That was dry.
Okay, how do you put this on?
I like the first shirt I gave you.
Oh, it's too big for his mouth. He's stretching his jaws to get around it.
Oh.
Give me your stocking.
Daddy,
no, it's full of candy.
Yeah, put it up.
Mine doesn't have a hook on. Who's this one? Dad's doesn't have a hook on.
It does?
Someone's gonna have a hook on.
No, you just can't find it right yet.
Who was that?
Everyone has something on it. Okay.
Now let's all sit here and watch family TV.
We should probably clean this thing up today before the people come here.
Yeah, I'll be right back.
Ew!
Now I can see it.
Oh my god! Why is it off?
I'm going to put stuff in my room.
That's a good idea. Wow!
Starting an avalanche!
Brad, just leave your other TV in your room for today's place.
My other TV? Which is the other
all
one?
All TV.
I'll leave it in a dumpster near a canister.
Yeah.
Serious. Okay, let's not try to carry all at once. You're going to bend that poster, Brett. Leave the poster by itself.
Yeah, that's mine.
Wait, you find that little...
leather jacket like this. Bouncers. Cute. Wake up. Well, you had it over there.
No, I don't know.
It's down there.
I'm gonna
find it.
Everybody covered my stuff. This is a huge thing.
Yeah.
But don't hit the tariff up your clothes when you're trying on.
Trying on?
Yeah.
Why?
Because the kids have to
hang
reach
them up. Hang them up now. Bring them all wrinkled.
All right, take that in. That's one load.
Go hang, put them on hangers.
I'm looking for a leather jacket.
We'll find it. Put this stuff on hangers.
Okay, I can't feel my toes.
What?
What is the temperature? Well, where is everyone?
I'm getting a numbness in my legs.
You put the cat thing out there?
Yep. They seem to like the cat next to it.
How did you put the... How's it with the house?
I don't know. I just threw it out there.
Because I kept them tucked in the house all night.
I know. I saw it. It's nice.
You can turn that off.
Bye. Merry Christmas. We'll take some more later.